Hey guys, we're out for ReveMoto. So today we're going to be doing this install on 2017 Lexus ES350 passenger side side view mirror, removal and installation. If you guys like this video, go ahead and like, subscribe and turn on that push notification. And if you guys need this mirror for your vehicle, color match and ready to install with the help of this video, the link is up above and also down below. And you can get all your pre-painted auto body parts at RevMoto.com, your pre-painted auto body parts source. Let's go ahead and get started. So from the back side, it doesn't look like it's broken, but I'm sure you guys can see right here, the cap is broken right here, and also the glass is broken. So this one's gonna need the whole assembly. So first things first, so we're gonna go ahead and open that door and we're gonna take off a couple of covers here. All right, so we have this cover right here and we're gonna go ahead and get something flat to pry that cover off. And the cover looks like this. And I believe there's gonna be another cover right here. So right here where the door handle is, or not door handle, I guess it's like the armrest area. There's gonna be a cover right inside here. So you can usually just use your hands to get it out. So you guys can see it's like a little triangle, like foam-like thing. You guys can see inside there, it's gonna be a screwdriver and a screwdriver to take those screws out. So I'll start off up here. All right, so get yourself a screwdriver. It looks like a star like that. Take this one up. So that's your screw right there. There's another one in there. Looks like that. All right, once those screws are taken off of the armrest and also right here where the door handle is, go ahead and pry the, actually, nope. We got another one right here. There's another screw that you gotta take off right here. And it looks like that. And it just came from right here. So let me take a look, see if there's any other screws. All right, I believe that's all. So you can go ahead and use your hand and try to pry the door handle, the door panel off. Things getting caught up right here. So let me see if we have to take off the controller too. So again, use something flat and soft. Yep, so there's another screw just down there. So you guys can see right there, there's another screw. Go ahead and unplug this. So as you guys can see, when I try to pull it and it wasn't really coming off easily, I didn't try to force it because I knew something else was holding it back. So there you go, there's a screw right here. We're going to take that off. Now, this thing should come right off now. There you go. So right behind here is gonna be these bolts. So let me see, let me take this off. We may have to take these off, but let me just see if I can get those bolts from here. You know what? I believe we can get in there. So let me show you guys where the bolts are. All right, so if you guys go in there, it might be a little tight for you guys if you guys want to remove this, but we'll see during the removal process if I need to take these off. But if you guys go all the way back there, so you guys kind of see those two bolts right there and another one on this side right there. Kind of hard to see because it's dark in there, but those are the two bolts you're going to take off, or screws. So it's going to be a 10 millimeter. Let's see if I can show you guys that right there. And locate that bolt. So you guys can see I'm not unplugging it yet. Here's the plug for that mirror, but I'm not unplugging it yet just because I don't want it to fall. And easily slide it out so it doesn't fall behind the door. So you guys can see there's one right there. Second one right there. Third one is over here. And actually, if you guys look right here, you guys can actually see the bolts. All right, that's the last one right there. So here's the plug right here. And I believe you have to take off this cover right here. So let me take this cover off. So there's a bolt right here, but I'm not gonna take it off. I just kind of slid it over. And there's this plug right here. And it's just taped onto this, it's like a little hook right here, or not a hook, it's like a little clip, but it's just taped on there. So we're gonna go ahead and just pull it like that. Then we're gonna go ahead and unplug it, okay? But let me show you guys how I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna zoom the camera out. All right, so once I unplug it, I'm gonna hold on to it. So unplug it, hold on to it, then get your other hand and try to wiggle this out. There you go, and let it slide. And just watch. So look at the wire right here and see that it goes behind the window regulator. So just making sure that you guys go behind the window regulator when you guys actually put the wire in place. Because if you don't, and you put it straight through here and plug it up, what's gonna happen is that whenever the window goes down, it won't be able to go all the way down. This wire is gonna be caught up on it. So before you guys take it off, just go ahead and look at where the wire is and how it's wrapping around the window regulator. Okay, go ahead and pull it out. All right, so here's our damaged one right here. So here's our new one right here. And again, if you guys need this particular mirror for your vehicle, the link is down below where you guys can purchase this mirror, color match, and ready to install at RevMoto.com. Okay? So you guys can see right here also, it comes with this tab. So we're gonna go ahead and take off this one right here. So, pretty easy. Sometimes you can just yank it off. Or use something flat. All right, so it's a little clip right here that we just went ahead and took off. So let me just angle this a little bit higher so you guys can see how I'm gonna put this mirror in place. So here's our brand new mirror. Slide it in there, and just wrap this mirror around, just like so. And then go ahead and look at the bolts and also the hole and line it up with the studs with the holes. Wrap this in there, plug it up, like that, and then plug it in just like that, and then you can go ahead and remove your hand and it should stay in place. Okay, so I'm gonna go and put all the bolts back in place. So for me, I like to go ahead and take off the ratchet and then actually put it in with my hands. So this one's actually at an angle, so it might be easier for me to take this off. So I just took one off and left this one there so I can just slide it down. And let's see if I can go ahead and put this in. A lot easier. There we go. Get the last one in. All right, so now I'm gonna go ahead and tighten everything up. So once you feel it grip, just have to do it like a small little turn, just like that. So you don't have to turn it forcefully. Just go ahead and give it a little bit of a turn like that. That should be more than enough. All right, here we go. And put this sticker back on there. I'm gonna go ahead and put this bolt back on the module. Alright guys, before we put everything back into place, we're gonna go ahead and test the mirror that it works properly. So go ahead and turn on the car and see how the functions work. Alright guys, so now everything works properly. I'm gonna go ahead and put everything back into place. So I'm gonna put you guys back here so you guys can see the installation process.
So I'm gonna go ahead and put this cover back on.
So the door panel goes over this ledge right here. Make sure your wires come out right here. And then this is one thing that kind of fell out. Put that back in here. Oh, that thing fell out. So I guess this thing goes in like this first. Okay. Go ahead and snap it into place. Then we're gonna go ahead and plug it up. Again, get the wires, and then it goes over.
So you have to angle it first like this. Ooh, it's getting stuck on something. So it's getting stuck on this little prong right here, and there's a hole right here, so you gotta match it up to that hole. So I'm gonna go ahead and take this wire and put it through here. Get this wire, put it through here. So the problem we're having right now is that this thing right here needs to sit properly, like in the perfect way, so it goes over the ledge. Or if it doesn't, then it just keeps sticking out. So that's what I'm trying to figure out right now. You also have this little prong looking thing that goes in a hole that's messing up the alignment. Or it should be really easy. There we go. So I just have to kind of pound on it a little bit to get this door panel to go down. Then I kind of look back here, just make sure all the holes and the prongs match up. And once it does match up, you can just go ahead and hit it. They should all clip. Oh, this one needs to go back in there. And once you pull on it, all those clips should be in place. This clip right here kind of fell back, so let me just take that off. Okay, so now if you guys pull on it, it should be secured and shouldn't just fall off. All right, here we go. So now, I'm going to go ahead and put this I'm going to go ahead and put this light back into place. I'm gonna go ahead and put this bolt back into place. Remember, it's the yellow one or silverish looking one. Actually, they're all silver. But this is a longer one, but it also looks kind of goldish. And it goes right here. It plugs up right here. And the smaller one, like this one, goes right here. Longer one goes in here. All right. Put your cover back in place. This one right here. And then last but not least, this little, just like a stopper right here, which is this one right here. And now we're gonna go ahead and test out the window to make sure it goes all the way down. All right guys, that's how you install a 2017